that.
Welcome students to Money and Banking. This unit is required to be done by the Certificate in Banking and Finance students, and today we'll discuss whatever is in our course outline. Now in this unit we'll be learning through notes which I'll be posting on the portal. You'll be required to log in and write down the notes, and then we'll be having either a Zoom class or a video such as this one where I'll be explaining whatever we've learned. So for today, I know we've already had the audio of the course outline, so today let's do a video where I explain whatever is required in our course outline. Our first topic is money. Here we'll define what money is. We'll talk about the history of the Kenyan currency and how it has been used and so on. Then we'll talk about the origin of money. Where did money come from? Did people just wake up and decide that this is what money is and this is how we use it? Then we'll also talk about the different forms of money. Okay? The different forms of money that exist and the history of money. And then after that we'll go to our second topic, where we'll talk about the evolution of money. How did money evolve? Because remember, money did not just come, like I said previously, just as a go. It had a few steps that came through. So under this we'll talk about the history of banking. Okay, here we'll talk about the banking history, because the banking history is the one that brought about money in the society. Then we'll also talk about the evolution of the banking system in Kenya. Since you are doing our KNEC exams, we really need to dwell on the Kenyan history. Then we'll talk about the Kenyan monetary institutions. The Kenyan monetary institutions. Now, the monetary institutions, these are the institutions that play a major role in deciding the control, the supply, and the demand for money. In this case, we'll talk about the central bank and how it works as the part that controls all commercial banks. So we'll talk about the central bank, the commercial banks, the SACCOs, and now the chambers, and so on. All these are part of the Kenyan monetary institutions. Then we'll talk about credit creation. Now this is usually a process of creating credit. Now this question is always asked in the KNEC exams, where you're told in less than maybe for 10 or 15 marks, explain how money is created. Money is created through the process called the credit creation process. So we'll talk about that, and then the limitations that are usually required so that you don't create a lot of money in the society. Then we'll talk about lending. Lending is the borrowing, or the opposite of borrowing, where if person A is borrowing, the other person is lending. The person that borrows gets lent. So we'll talk about how the bank usually lends. What are the things that they usually look at different customers to know how much to lend them, and so on. And then we'll still talk about the canons or the principles. The canons or the principles of lending. And then we'll differentiate different types of lending. After that, we'll talk about money transfer systems. We really understand that we have different ways that money is transferred. You use M-Pesa, you use a lot of ways to transfer money. Therefore, this is the part where we discuss them. Then we'll talk about other banking services. Okay, here we'll talk about the checking system there. How people usually pay internationally. We'll talk about checks, we'll talk about the letters of credit, the traveler's check, and so on. Then we'll have the internal control system. Now, a bank usually has to know how will it transact its goods, how will it transact its goods and services so that it can get something out of it. A bank does not want to transact, it does not want to find a situation where the members of the bank itself are the ones taking the loans, are the ones getting the loans from the bank and using them. So the bank has to find some internal control system. Finally, we talk about the different types of customer bank accounts. So you have the student bank accounts, you usually have the business bank accounts, and so on. That's all that you'll be learning under money and banking. I hope you guys are psyched. We'll have a very great semester. Like I've said, you'll be having notes classes, video classes, and Zoom classes. I hope to your psych. Let's meet in class. Thank you, and let's have a great semester.